While we are in a very challenging environment at the moment, we do have a committee established under Deputy Governor to deal with gangs. There's an anti-gang strategy we will be meeting shortly. As it stands at the moment, we're doing well operationally. We may have to come back to speak about resources, but we'll know more when we have our first meeting with Deputy Governor shortly. And we're dealing with, we would say globally, three disparate groups in Georgetown Central, West Bay, and a younger group then, next generation persons involved in criminality. So there is a gang element to it, more disorganized groups, loosely associated, young persons, predominantly male, with an intersperse of some young females involved, supporting them in terms of logistics. We are making good progress. We do have some challenges in terms of getting information from the community, but generally we're doing quite well in terms of our investigations, and we have to monitor the situation going forward. It is serious, not to be underestimated. It will require a lot of resilience and a constant focus going forward.
Is it drugs? Is it some other crime element? Why this is happening?
Commissioner?
Chairman, thank you. It's a multiplicity of factors, and we have identified it has to do with territory, hierarchy, guns, drugs, conflict, females and males. It's a wide mix of issues. The smallest conflict can escalate into resulting in gun crime, result in an issue with gun crime. So it is a multiplicity of issues. We are picking up information. The difficulty is trying to convert that to intelligence, to convert it to evidence, to prosecute people, and that is a challenge.